So now we have moved on to Malaysia. And in Malaysia today, we have our special guest, sister, a teacher, Li Yuqing. And teacher Li Yuqing, when I visited Malaysia, when teacher Mei Yim visited Malaysia, teacher Li Yuqing will always be accompanying her every day. And all the time she'll be accompanying me. And she would say that she wants to learn from our Taiwan speakers. And actually, teacher Mei Yim said that we should now be learning from Malaysian teachers. So this is the Malaysia KL branch. The education mission, they have a closing ceremony for all the education camp. And teacher Yuqing shared that they hope that in education, it's all about inspiring the youth for them to be a better person. So whenever she comes to Taiwan or when we go over to Malaysia, we can see that our teachers, our tziji teachers are always educating the local students. So we can see that when we promote the Pagamo online gaming competition, our teachers are very encouraging to all the students. And also, our teachers are also bringing the teachings of Jingzi aphorism to the Malay teachers, to the local Malay teachers. And they're using the local Malay language to share with the teachers. And they have to overcome the language challenge and to bring the message across and the teachings behind to all the local teachers. Let's come to Malaysia now. I love to be with you because you have positive energy. Now we have a teacher Li Yuqing from Malaysia. Everybody, good morning. My name is teacher Li Yuqing. I would like to share the topic today. It's love accompaniment and tutoring through the clouds. And during the pandemic, our volunteers are very busy distributing the equipment and material. And as a teacher, you know, we have to be very clear and focus on our education mission. And we need to inspire more people to join us, you know, to help the local students. So we gather the volunteers from charity and education and combine them to provide the relief to the students during the pandemic. And we hope that through this way, we want the students to have that the sense of learning and wanting to return back to school, because during pandemic, the educations are all being disrupted. And so we gather together and convergence the different function groups in Tziji, including charity, education, the Duifu, the leaders, to join us. And in this year, January, we have started our lessons, online lessons, and there were 73 tutors, teachers with 196 students and 89 classes with 21 humanity classes and more than 250 volunteers. And at the beginning, the initial stage, we have lots of challenges. And these are the 9 major challenges that we encounter. The 2 major ones are the attendance of the students are very low due to the instability of the internet connections. So during our first month, the January attendance, we only reached 55% attendance. And because of the low turnout of the students, it also affected the teachers' turnout. And our charity foundation Sister Susan mentions that in order to educate a child, we need the whole village. And so now we need to, we started the online home visits and to interact with the parents as well as the students through our love and care and concern for them, to encourage them to come and learn, to come online and continue the studies online. And we hope that we can closely bring them and accompany them in this journey to those who have affinities with Ziji. So we can see our attendance start to increase. And these are the feedbacks from the parents. And total of 73%, most majority of the parents are giving positive feedbacks, positive responses. And because of love, and the love that we are giving out, we are getting the love back in return. And this is one of the tutor. She's also a private tuition center's teacher. And during the Chinese New Year celebration, she conducted an online gathering for all the students. And she uses a lot of tools and materials to help the students to learn, as well as the teachers, to enable the teachers to have the right tools to teach effectively online. And this is actually a university lecturer, and so he is also helping our teachers, to accompany our teachers, to guide them, to provide the right way of teaching. And through this process, this professor, lecturer, he actually he got inspired again as to why he joined the education industry in the first place. And this is our sister, a volunteer commissioner, who is a small team leader that accompany the families and the students. So her case that she's in charge of, it's a single mother, single parent with 7 children.
So
she is very, very very involved in every single child's attendance and ensuring that these children come online and able to learn through the online sessions, tutoring. And we can see that at the end of our program, we can see that five of their of these children had obtained a performance awards, and they have improved greatly. And this is another teacher, a volunteer teacher. He will visit the home of the student, and then he brought the student, because the student is she's introvert. So the teacher brought the student to our recycling point to get her involved in the recycling activity. So let's watch this video on the award ceremony. The song is in Malay. It's about our children. What we can do for our children. And this is a team leader, our volunteer, and she sees the opportunity to accompany the students. And this teacher sister shared that the parents told her that their children have improved in their academics. And these students say that he became more confident and he got A for his English. The sister mentioned that this is a very meaningful program, because she's able to help these students and not neglecting them. And seeing their improvements in their studies, it really made her feel very, very joyful. So this is the lyrics of the new song that was just written by our team. And it's very touching and describing the dedication of our teachers and volunteers towards our students. And it's not because we see hope that we dedicate ourselves, but rather when we dedicate ourselves and persevere, then we will see the hope. Thank you so much. Okay, we are grateful to teacher Yi Qing for her sharing. And it's not just not when we see hope that we will persevere, but rather we should persevere, then we can be able to see hope.
雪龙的玉清去看到，真的就是无论我们在哪里，
okay, regardless of where we are, we are always putting in the effort, putting the effort to help the needy. And this is the strength that every one of us have. And yes, in the mission of education, teacher Yi Qing has always dedicated herself and selflessly contributing to education field. And teacher Mei Yin says, sometimes we have to go overseas to other countries to learn from the other teachers. And let's give a round a big applause to our teacher Yi Qing.
Yi Qing, 你也太厉害了，你现在变成是一边读书。